Hi, my name is Brock Kleweno. I'm the chef at Yamashiro restaurant in Hollywood. I'm going to be taking you inside my sushi kitchen and we're going to show you our forbidden rice roll. So this is Rigo Alvarez. He is the sushi chef at Yamashiro, and we do a lot of sushi at Yamashiro. Over half of what we do comes out of Rigo's kitchen. Either it's raw, sushi, sashimis, or rolls. Today he's going to make the forbidden rice roll. It's called the forbidden rice because we're using black forbidden rice. The black rice is an heirloom variety of rice. I like to use it because it's a lot healthier, it has antioxidants, it's got a lot of protein, and it's got a lot of fiber. We still mix it with a little bit of traditional sushi rice to get the right consistency and make sure it's sticky enough that he can actually make the rolls. So he's putting a little bit of the black forbidden rice on nori, which is the seaweed wrapper. Then what goes in the filling is our spicy tuna. We use big eye or yellowfin ahi tuna. We mix it with our homemade spicy mayonnaise, which is our secret concoction of a whole bunch of chilies and homemade mayonnaise. Nori, that's traditionally what you would use on a sushi roll. We use soy paper sometimes, which is based off of soy and it's doesn't really have a flavor, but for the most part our rolls are in nori, which is a dried seaweed. In the first place we were wanting to work with black rice because again we wanted to incorporate a healthier sushi rice into our menu, and when we first did it, it had the red of the spicy mayonnaise, the red of the tuna, and the black, and it reminded us of Star Wars and Darth Vader. So we originally called this roll the Darth Vader roll. So here's the spicy tuna. She puts a dollop of that in the middle. Next, he'll have a couple cucumbers. At Yamashiro, we have like all the traditional rolls, traditional sushis, but what we've really tried to do with the menu is give a little something interesting, a little something different to appeal to all our guests that range from novice people that really don't go out that much to really experienced diners and foodies and that sort of thing. He has a little avocado in there, and now he's going to roll it. He takes his bamboo mat just to make sure the roll is tight enough so that when he slices it, the rolls stay nice and firm and they can be plated and presented. The other reason I like the black rice is that it's just beautiful when it's on the plate. Okay, you get 6 pieces out of it. So you can really see the juxtaposition between the black and the red and the green with this roll. For a little extra flavor, he takes the same spicy mayonnaise that's mixed in with the ahi tuna, and he's gonna put that on the plate. Stands them on end. And then to garnish and make it even more exciting, I have him put extra avocado because I love avocado. When we first started this, I think he was almost wanted to not like me so much because it's such a difficult thing when we're doing so many of these rolls all at once. But as you can see, he can really slice the avocado beautifully and thinly, and it just lays on the roll perfectly. And then the final garnish is tobiko, which is flying fish roe. It's a type of caviar. You see it in a lot of different sushis. We add it for a little extra color, and it actually has a little saltiness and a little crunch when you're biting into the roll. And just a little dollop on each piece. There's orange tobiko, there's black tobiko, there's green tobiko, which is infused with wasabi. There's a kind of pink tobiko that's infused with ginger. There's a whole bunch of different varieties, but we like the black because it went with the black rice. Some people will order this roll sometimes with spicy yellowtail instead of spicy tuna, a little bit here and there. Once in a while, they'll want it with soy paper instead of the nori. But for the most part, this roll comes out the way it is. It's our number one selling roll, and that is the forbidden rice roll. Like I said, we have guests that are from every different culture, every different food knowledge range. We'll have traditional sushi, we have traditional rolls, but then we try to play with stuff for people who may not know sushi very well, or maybe a little intimidated by raw selections. That makes it a little bit more user-friendly to eat. So that was our forbidden rice roll with the tobiko and the black forbidden rice. Again, I really love using that black rice because of its health benefits. You can get it at specialty stores in Japantown, Koreatown, Little Tokyo, for other dishes as well.